The story of a bold experiment, a GLC idea actually, to tackle the problem of 17,000 families on London's housing waiting list by offering a lot of older people a happy retirement away from it all. But as Graham Addicott reports, success for the scheme is elusive.
For 9 years, the GLC has been running a remarkable scheme whereby their council tenants can retire by the sea. But behind these people's happiness lies a growing tragedy for people like Dick Felstead. For the whole of his 69 years, Dick has lived in the East End of London. For the last 38, in the same two-bedroom council house in Plaistow. But in the last decade, he and his wife Celia have become disillusioned.
Well, there's no shops here. I think shutting up, you've got nowhere to go properly. All the big co-ops are shutting, all the big stores. So where have you got to go and shop? You've got the market, you've got to have your purse on a bit of string. You just have it just snatched out your hand.
The encroaching tower blocks and the ending of the East End way of life led the Felsteads 6 years ago to apply for a GLC retirement home. The scheme started in 1964 as an attempt to entice retired couples out of council homes, thus freeing them for families on the waiting list. The Felsteads needed no enticement.
I think London is dying, myself. There's no flow of industry going in there now, and all you see is office blocks going up. And down Silvertown Way, where there used to be about 30 factories, there's only one left.
In the 6 years that the Felsteads have been on the waiting list, they'd never actually visited one of their dream bungalows on the coast. So, reporting London took them to the town they've applied to go to, Clacton-on-Sea in Essex. For many Londoners, especially those from the East End, Essex is the place to move to if you want to get away from the city. For pensioners like the Felsteads on a low fixed income, it would be impossible but for the GLC scheme. Back in London, they have to pay £20 a week for their GLC house. Here in Clacton, the Felsteads would have to pay around the same for a much smaller bungalow. Altogether, there are 115 GLC bungalows and 8 flats on 3 estates in Clacton. We took the Felsteads to the home of 62-year-old Violet Newman. For £19 a week, including rates, Mrs. Newman gets a small but very comfortable two-bedroom bungalow. Before retiring, she'd been living in a large three-bedroom council house in London. So, for the GLC, the scheme makes sound economic sense, as the bungalows cost just a half of what it would cost to build a family home in the capital.
Now, this is the bedroom. This is the main bedroom, the double bedroom.
That's right.
It's a lovely, bright, sunny room, and get a lot of pleasure out of this. Nice double wardrobe, fitted wardrobe.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Plenty of space. Considering it's bungalow, there's plenty of space. Now we have
Mrs. Newman lives here alone since her husband died 3 years ago. The GLC claim that one sign of the scheme's success and popularity is that since it was started, hardly any pensioners have asked to return to London when their spouse died. Indeed, less than 1% of their seaside tenants have ever asked to move back to London for any reason whatsoever.
As you can see, it's nice open space. We get, and I spend hours and hours in the summer in it.
Yeah, it's very nice.
Really lovely. Nice. Yeah. Do you have a garden?
Not much of one.
Yeah, just a little one.
Yes, very.
Ironically, Mrs. Newman's happiness and pride in her home serve to highlight the cruelty of the position the Felsteads now find themselves in. They've been on the waiting list for a retirement home here in Clacton for 6 years. On that waiting list with them are over 1,300 other retired couples. But in the last couple of years, the GLC have been running down the scheme and are now even refusing some couples places on the waiting list.
I was several places, but as the children was down here, we thought we'd like to come down to Clacton when we retire. Well, we're both retired now.
Well, you've got so much to walk, haven't you? Where have you got to walk where we live? Top of the street and sort of back, that's all you've got. I mean, I haven't got anything else, really.
You've been to see, you went today, to see one of the houses, or one of the bungalows.
Yes.
What do you think of them?
Marvellous. Oh,
Oh, that'd be marvellous. Oh, people,
wouldn't you? I'd be the moon to have that. Yeah, it's beautiful.
If you were told right now, OK, you've got one, you can move in next week, how would you feel?
And with the moon, just my dream. Dream come true.
Clacton-on-Sea in Essex isn't the only place that the GLC have retirement homes. Over 3,000 people now live in homes situated from as far north as Skegness to as far south as here, the Cornish coast around Newquay.
The seaside village of Allaghan is just a few miles south of Newquay. Here in 1981, the GLC built 45 semi-detached and terraced bungalows. Although the local district council collects the rents on behalf of the GLC, officers like manager Stella Cooper and senior projects manager Roger Eldridge regularly make the trip down from London to check that everything's all right. There are now 3,200 retirement homes. One important job is to check that those special designs put into the bungalows to meet the needs of the elderly are working properly.
The alarm system.
A little light?
That's a little light up there.
Oh, yes, it works.
It works okay,
yes.
Does it?
Yeah. Because we do that once a month.
Yeah, just to see that it's working.
Just to see that it's working.
Good.
Lovely.
So, yes, it's working.
All right.
Good. Okay. Right, nice to see you.
Thank you.
Yes.
See you again.
To head off any feelings from the locals that London's elderly are just being dumped on them, the GLC always gives the district council a percentage of the homes for their retired. Here in Allaghan, it's 5 of the 45 bungalows. And this community centre was also designed to be used by all of Allaghan's elderly, not just those from London. But in a sense, it's the very fact that most of these people come from a shared background that makes the retirement scheme the success it is. For many elderly people, retirement to a dream home by the sea rapidly turns to loneliness and isolation from their roots. These people bring their community with them. Some, like Agnes, are even just coming home.
I was born in St. Ives, and I met my husband down St. Ives. I came to London to work, and being retired, I wanted to come back.
What do you think of this scheme?
Oh, I think it's marvellous. Well, I'm very happy here.
Reg, can I ask you, when did you leave London to move down here?
Roughly 2 years ago.
And how long have you been living in London?
All our lives.
We are Londoners.
We are Londoners, you see.
We were born
in London.
And we lived for 42 years in the house. We left to come here.
So the same place?
Yes.
Yes.
What do you think of it down here?
Oh, it's fabulous. Wonderful.
It seems that's one big holiday to us, you know, it's never going to end. We couldn't realise, could we, really?
Well, I had to pinch myself on and off to make sure I'm awake.
And this is our
not dreaming at all.
But for many of the 1,300 or so couples on the waiting list back in London, the dream of ever getting a retirement home is rapidly fading. This is Perranporth, just a few miles from Allaghan. Just 2 weeks ago, the GLC began building here. 40 retirement flats costing £800,000 are due to be completed by April next year. The GLC say these are likely to be the last retirement homes they'll ever build. To build new homes, the GLC has to use its own capital or borrow from government. It can't use the rates. But the government have said that they just don't have the money.
The GLC isn't running it down, the government is running it down. The government have said to us quite clearly they don't want us to build, do any new build. We've had a few schemes that have been knocking around for some time that we have got approval to go ahead with, but the government's intention is quite clear, and they're saying other land that we have acquired, that we could continue the building programme, they're saying we want part of the agreement of getting the new build agreed this year is that we sell off the land. So that is the end, so that any potential for the future has been taken away from us by this government.
The single greatest priority for most London local authorities, including the GLC, is to provide small-scale accommodation that is for the elderly, because they know that is the cheapest and quickest way in which they can release family accommodation. Now, I actually don't care a great deal where that elderly accommodation is provided. It's not my business to go around saying people are better off living on the coast than they are living in the centre of London. If there is a real demand by people who are coming up to the age of retirement or who are already retired for houses in that location or flats in that location, if in fact they would accept transfers there where they might not accept a transfer locally because they might feel it was just a nuisance to them to move locally and they wouldn't gain very much from it. If the demand is there, then for goodness sakes, let's do it, because that's the way that we can start getting families off the waiting lists.
With the collapse of the retirement home programme, couples like Dick and Celia Felsted are in the macabre position of literally having to wait for someone now occupying a seaside home to die before they get their home by the sea. The greater tragedy for London is that at least 1,300 other homes, capable of housing some 5,000 people, will remain under-occupied and underused for the foreseeable future.
A long and ever longer wait for a dream retirement home. And that's all from us tonight. Until Tuesday, good night.